There are a few things you do need to know while using the API Designer, and the best way to learn those things is through a simple example. So, say we want to create an API called Fix It Fast Incident Report. We add an API name, which becomes part of the URL for the API, a quick description, click Create, done. Now, as a mobile app developer, you're creating the interface to the API or the contract that describes the API's correct behavior. Someone else is probably writing the implementation that actually goes after the data. Anyway, if you're just describing the data you need for someone else to implement, the only thing you really need to pay attention to here is the Endpoints tab. An endpoint is just a noun called a resource and a verb called a method. A single API usually has multiple endpoints to describe the data you need and what you want to do with it. So let's see how to add a resource. We start with a noun, in this case, incidents. Say this API is for an app that lets homeowners request service from a company called Fix It Fast, so that the homeowner can get someone to come out and fix a leaky water heater or some other appliance problem. Each request is in the form of a service incident. We want the API to be able to fetch all the service incidents out of the backend system, like, say, Oracle Service Cloud. Now we need a verb, so we click Methods. We want the verb Get, so we can get all the incident reports currently in the system. The endpoint, Get Incidents, will do just that. There's nothing else we need to worry about on this page right now, so let's go back to the Endpoints page. Say we also want to be able to retrieve a single incident from the system based on the incident's unique ID. To do that, we'll add a nested resource. A nested resource is useful for when you want to zero in on a subset of a larger resource. The plus sign lets you add nested resources. We'll add a nested resource called ID based on the parent incidents. You know that it's nested because it's shown after the parent resource, which is highlighted in gray. We need a get method for this endpoint too, of course. In a few moments, you'll want to test this endpoint to make sure you're going to get back the data you expect. You could click Test now and take the steps to get a simple 200 response back, which means the call is successful. But let's make things a bit more interesting by supplying some mock data. This will make the endpoint behave more like it will when it's actually implemented. All you have to do is cut and paste some JSON into the API Designer, like this. Click Responses, then Add Response. Click Add Media Type. Click Example, and paste the JSON snippet. That's it! We have two endpoints now for our API, so let's not add any more. You can get the idea of how to do it. Now, let's test the endpoint that has the mock data, that is, the getIncident/ID endpoint. The first thing you need to do is go to the Security tab and allow anonymous user access. You probably wouldn't do this in real life. You'd probably enter a role that pertains to your mobile users. But for testing purposes, it's fine. Before you can test an endpoint in MCS, it has to be associated with a mobile backend. A mobile backend allows you to develop and deploy groupings of APIs that are designed to support a specific set of applications. In this case, we're developing our API in a mobile backend called Fix It Fast, so we'll select that. Voila! Check out the response! Now you've got some well-formed JSON with proper data, mimicking what will eventually come back from the implemented API. By defining many endpoints and supplying mock data like this, you can build up an entire mock API to code against, so you can do some rapid prototyping without having to wait for the API to actually be implemented in JavaScript. You now should have enough information to go off and write your own API in the API Designer.